I'm Erika Nesvold, and I'm an astrophysicist and video game developer, but I also think and write and talk a lot about the ethics of space exploration and space settlement. A lot of people these days are really excited about the idea of humans living and working in space. In fact, they describe space as a blank slate where we could build these new, better communities. But space isn't a blank slate because we'll be bringing a lot of our baggage, our prejudices, and our biases with us into space. So we need to think really carefully and deliberately about the way we want to live together in space, to learn from the mistakes of our past so that we can build better futures for our descendants in space in the future. It's tough to figure out how humans as a whole, as a species, can make these huge decisions about the future of our species and our descendants in space. But it's crucial that we try to incorporate as many different perspectives and viewpoints as possible as we move into the future. And that's because we want our descendants in space to carry forwards the cultures and the values of everyone from their home planet on Earth, not just the organizations or companies or nations that happen to get there first. So there's a lot of different fields that are working on different pieces of this big puzzle of how do we live ethically in space. So that's not just the engineers and scientists focused on the hardware and the physics problems of building the rockets and building habitats that can protect human bodies in space. But that's also the people who study how humans live together, how they can address interpersonal harms, how they can structure their economies to make sure that nobody falls through the cracks, which would be a very big issue in a space settlement. And so people like sociologists and anthropologists can give us a lot of their expertise from the history of humans on Earth. Historians, of course, and especially the historians of colonization on Earth can tell us about all the harms that colonization has caused in the past and provide some cautionary tales of how we might accidentally repeat those mistakes in the future if we're not careful. And then, of course, there's the philosophers and ethicists who are experts in thinking about these ideas and in figuring out how to balance all the different concerns and motivations in a big thorny problem like space settlement. So members of the public who want to be a part of this discussion, first of all, that's the first step, is to say this is an issue that you care about and to start having those conversations with each other, with organizations that you think represent the ideals that you want to see presented in space. So you can support organizations that advocate for a healthier society in space. And you can also support organizations that are already doing this kind of work here on Earth today. Because if we can solve the biggest problems we face on Earth, like how to protect our environment from our massive species-wide industry, and how to live together when we all have different concepts of how we should build a society, if we can come up with solutions on Earth for these problems, not only will we make our lives better and our children's lives better here on Earth, but we'll have better values and systems to build as we expand out into space.